Well, this map here. Oh, I'm used to playing blue. The counter terrorists have to run in and get these hostages, and the team I'm on, terrorists, we just have to stop them from doing that. But I found more often, like all games, hostages really aren't dealt with. This game especially, it's more about just killing. And you'll see, it's all about these same hallways. Everyone just camps in these same hallways. And that's why I don't really like this game mode too much. It's usually just a standoff in the same hallways as usual. Okay. Oh yeah, can you give me some gas nade tips for Shanghai Blue Team? Like good places to throw. Thank you for all your help. I suggest throwing it anywhere that red is like camping or rushing. So more than likely it's gonna be in that first little like say you're sitting at the sub but kinda near that warehouse, right in front of that warehouse. It'll be on the right side, that little junction there. So that's probably where more people rush than any other spot, because the left is easily defended. But just figure out where the enemy is and kind of throw it there. 17, a fair. Do you know if you have to play 1 hour straight without logging off to get a raffle, or does the minutes add up? Thanks. You can log off. It's all about just how much time you are in game for the whole day. I've done it and it's added up, so that's all you gotta do. 18. Hey, Fer, did you see that lunar eclipse on Wednesday, February 20th, 2008? It was cool. No, I didn't see it, but I've seen some before. If you didn't, sucks for you. Yeah, I guess it does. Sorry, I forgot to tell you about it. Whatever, I knew it was there anyway, just no time. If you did you think it was kind of cool? No, I didn't see it, but I like the other ones I've seen are great. Awesome, I love that stuff. And are you ever going to think about putting a certain limit of number of questions per episode? Maybe. You never know. Okay, let me buy a weapon here. The AK, or the CV, whatever they call it. I don't even know. I don't play this game enough. Yeah, they kill me pretty quick. But, I don't know. I'm gonna go find another map because this is just gonna take too long and I'm really bored. Okay, this is Dust. A lot of people like this map. Why can't I buy anything? Let's try this. Oh, they probably banned it like everyone else. Let's use the HK. Yeah, this one, team has to plant the bomb, and another team has to defend it. So, yeah. Just kind of like Soldier Front. I don't really play this much either. Everyone plays this map, I don't really find it too cool. Oh, man. Dang it. Okay, so I'm just gonna play this one more time. I'll just stop and restart when the game starts because there's like 50 people in this room. Okay, finally, new round. Rifles. Yep, I don't really have much to say. Sorry, but. I suck at this game. So there's really no use watching me. Go watch some videos on YouTube or something. So next up, how about a little watching of Deadpool 135 with the M4 on Soldier Front. So stay tuned, but I'll be talking. All right. Well, thanks for not changing the station or whatever, but here's Deadpool playing with his M4. He's much better than I am. He doesn't have sound though. Yeah, he's much better than I am, so I figured why not have him play a little bit. We got some extra time, right? Right. So basically what you burst most of the time?
Yeah.
All the time?
Most of
the time.
Okay.
Or hold it down most. Hold it down or burst. Yeah, the M4, it has changed. A lot of people, I think I had a question asking if I thought the M4 changed. I never really used it, so I don't know. My brother said yes, it changed. Another friend of mine said yes, he thought it changed. It definitely changed. So I checked it out, and when you, I just stood still and held it down full auto many times, and it was shooting in pretty much a straight path. So yeah, it changed. It used to be you'd hold it down and it'd actually spray around, but now it just shoots kind of like the FAMAS. That's how accurate it is, except, you know, the crosshairs move. I think that's why it's so cheap, but so it's pretty accurate now, as long as you can control it. Just, you don't follow your crosshair sometimes, you just you're gonna have to kind of rely on figuring out where the bullets are going. Just takes experience for that. And let's just watch him play. Nice, nice, nice. Oh yeah. All right. Yeah, so you can pretty much go full auto and it's going to be accurate. So it's a pretty good gun, but I'll talk a little more if he dies, all right. Man, that's a quick kill. It's fierce, man. It's really fierce now. You think it was good before. Now it's just insane. It might be the best assault rifle. Actually, right now I'm thinking it is. So, the best gun in the game, not counting PSG. At least I think so. Just because you have full mobility. Full accuracy, pretty decent damage. I don't know exact damage, but high rate of fire, full accuracy, full mobility. That's a pretty strong combination. Where the AN, you can't go full auto. You don't have a high rate of fire, at least as high as this gun. Just because you can't go full auto all the time, you can only go as fast as you can single fire or burst, you know, full auto up close. But let's just see here. It's a good thing to do. Yeah, if your teammates are covering in that bomb area, a good thing to do is just what Deadpool did, was go up on that back box and defend those steps so nobody gets flanked, and once your teammates die inside, then check the window. But yeah, main problem with the AN now is just the mobility. It's just not fast enough. It's harder to kill snipers and stuff. And anything, you know, anybody can beat it. You know, this gun has more mobility than you, so you can jump around, and the AN has to hit them. Can't miss.